I think my thoughts are quite ML thoughts, not binary. So it is not, I don't have a binary answer, yes, it happened or not. I think to some extent, this direction is still valid because we see that there are more people from soft, traditional software development coming to ML space, or maybe I should say LLM ops space, basically solving, are able to solve problems that before large language models were solvable using traditional ML or deep learning. So I see this movement that today more engineers are involved in AI projects. At the same time, large language models and working with them on production, it is something that, like, I'm not hearing very often about production, like really production, maybe use cases, yes, but really large language models being used in production, and as always, new capabilities, new algorithms, new techniques brings new challenges. So we have, like, in order to operate those models, we have even more requirements and things to solve than we used to have with more traditional ML deep learning models on production. So but in an essence, what I want to, like, my article, my thesis was about the similarity between those two spaces, tech stacks, methodologies, and how important it is that they would work together. And I think it is very, very relevant today, where you need, like, large language models very often are consumed through API. And it is something that very much has to work hand to hand with your traditional software where you're using it. So I think that this trends of those two fields are converging. Maybe it will be called differently, but getting closer is something we are going to see. What do you think, Aurimas, on that?
No, the background is that I'm coming from, I do believe that most of the challenges that we were solving in machine learning when it comes to operationalizing all of the processes were kind of already very close to DevOps. So I was always, I always had this also thought in my mind, but it is, you know, we don't need to create a new paradigm specifically for it. It's more of the extension of DevOps, right? But we cannot kind of follow completely the DevOps principles because, of course, there's data involved. But it's mostly around training processes and not necessarily serving processes. So not deployment of the models. When it comes to deployment of the models, what I've seen, it was always just a pure DevOps practice, right? So it's not that different. It's always, almost always served via API, as I mentioned. So the deployment is no different, apart from the fact that you need to load some big binary into memory and the results are non-deterministic, partially deterministic because it's still a very big kind of function underneath, but it's so big that we are having problems explaining it. But the patterns remain the same. You need to test it. You need to do maybe some blue-green deployments, maybe some canary releases, right? You can't avoid that. And the processes around it are the same.
I think just it will get even more DevOps-ish to some extent, because with the new models, if, for instance, if you want to combine large language model with some outputs from specialized deep learning model, a very natural way to do is to use it as agent for instance, of a large language model. And more agents you have, more dependencies, more versions to synchronize. And it is something that we are dealing with in software space for years. So I think it is, it will remain like that and gets more obvious how closely DevOps team needs to work with ML, LLMOps team, if they won't be called the same.
And actually, when it comes to, you mentioned agents, right? So all of these multi-agent systems where multiple LLMs are communicating between each other to produce final result. To me, it's like I'm also coming from partially from DevOps and cloud engineering background. To me, it seems very similar to what service meshes are trying to do. So the communication patterns, right? So you have proxies between kind of applications. So in our case, applications are large language models, but you still need to be able to trace what is happening in between, how the requests are traveling, where the errors occur.
Smarter proxies. No,
exactly. Black box applications, basically.
Yeah.
Of course, then there is the data side of things that is not as DevOpsish, right? So data itself is non-deterministic, but it's only kind of important when you're thinking about specifically monitoring machine learning models and in a specific way, not regular software practices related way, and training of models. But still, you can think about those processes. You can wrap all of those processes around regular monitoring practices. It's just what you do with the data that you receive is different, right?
I think that we'll see, like, around data, it would be a little bit more. I think, okay, maybe we should call it compliance, security, ethic, don't know, but what is the right term? But also on production, like how we would make sure that the data that model is getting wouldn't exploit model in a way that we don't want. So I think again, like, it's nothing new in software. Of course, we in traditional software, but I think that we'll see a development on this end as well. So I think GitLab is calling DevSecOps. Yeah, so maybe we'll be calling LMSecOps, or okay, I'm not good in names, but I think that there is that this area will be growing once more of those models, or once we have more and more companies applying those models on for production use cases, this will be important as well.